Welcome back to part two of the instructions for the second part of your project. So in this section, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to copy a question, create your question within Google Forms. Depending on the time frame for the video, I might show how to share your link, or I might do that for a different video. I guess I'll just kind of play it by ear here real quick. So here I have this particular question, which is which of the following statements is closer to your view? And so obviously that's, you know, not one of my questions. I want to put one of my questions in there. So what I do is I want to have my top line or the document that contains the questions that I'm copying available. And so we can just copy and paste sometimes, or you can just type them in. Now, for this particular course, I just want you to be aware that in Google Forms, you can do a bunch of different types of questions. You can do questions that sort of follow. So you can ask a yes or no question, and if they answered yes, then it'll take them to one page where they can sort of follow up on that yes. If they answer no, you take them to another page and they follow up on that no. And so you're welcome to do that if you want to, but for our purposes here, multiple choice is just sufficient for you to gather your data that you want to gather. And so I have here this particular question. What I'm going to do, I put my glasses, I can actually read them. I'm going to copy this question right here. Are you enrolled full-time? Are you enrolled in school either full-time or part-time or not? And so if I just copy this to make my life a little easier, I'm going to replace this question with that one. And so if I double click on it, you can see that it allows me to just copy my question, right? And of course here, let me just make sure that's right. And so here's my question. I'm gonna leave it as multiple choice. So now I'm creating a brand, you know, I'm replacing that question. And so the next thing that I want to do is I wanna look at my choices. So your response choices, exactly the way the question has it in the poll, is enrolled, full-time, part-time, not enrolled, don't know, refused. And so if I click on here, I can just go ahead and type in enrolled, double click that one, and type in full time. Now, if I want to add a response choice, I got to click on other. Once you click on other, if I click on add option, you notice that it becomes live for me to be able to type. And that's part time. I believe the next one is not enrolled. Excuse me. Not enrolled. And I think the next one is don't know. So I click on option. Don't know / refused. Now, notice how this line stays. And so if I don't want that, I have to exit out. And the reason being is because then when you share your poll, it's going to show up there. And you don't want your participants to click on it because it might just mess up your data. And so that's how you create a question. Now, the next thing is what happens to your responses. So if I click on responses here, this here will allow me, if I click on it, now if I share my poll, my participants can actually complete the poll. Now, one of the things that you can do here is you can actually, hold on a second, let me make sure, preview. So this is just a preview of the poll, and I'm going to show you what the question that we just copied is going to look like. And so that's the question that we copied. And so if I click on full-time and then part-time, notice how it doesn't allow me to do multiple clicks. So I can say enrolled, full-time, part-time, non-enrolled. And so what happens is that they're actually looking at this particular question as these responses, enrolled, full-time, part-time, as different responses. Now, let's say that I wanted to, actually, I'm going to leave this, that I wanted to have those actually multiple, right? So that I can click enrolled, and how am I enrolled? Am I enrolled full-time or part-time? And so for that particular one, you wouldn't do multiple choice, you would do the checkbox. And then so if I go back over here and I go to the question again, let me get to this question. I can click enroll and I'm enrolled part-time. So that's the difference between multiple choice and checkbox. It's entirely up to you. Some of the questions I would have, probably keep them separate. But you might, if you have a question like this, you might say, wait a minute, I want to know, yeah, they're enrolled, but I want to separate my participants between those that are full-time and part-time, right? It's maybe the data would be better that you collect. Leave this here. So that's how you create the question, and that's how it's going to look like, right? When you click on your responses, I'm going to get into some other videos later on to show you how to download them and start analyzing them. But make sure that you create your questions, you preview it to make sure it looks the way it should be. And when you're ready to share it, you'll know how to share it with your participants. There's a link that's gonna you're gonna be able to share, and I will go ahead and post that on the next video, probably this week. Thank you.